All right. What's up mga ka-investa? So ito na naman, meron na naman tayong bagong IPO, ang upcoming Monde Nissin company. So marami sa mga produkto nito ginagamit o kinakain natin sa pang-araw-araw. Kasama ko si Ray ngayon, ang ating investment banker na kaibigan, at tutulungan niya tayo para i-analyze ang Monde Nissin. Ray, kamusta?
Hey, what's up, JC? Thanks again for having me. What's up, mga ka-investa? So ito, second IPO of the year and the biggest one in the Philippines ever. So check natin ano bang laman ni Monde Nissin, paano natin siya i-value. So
right.
Monde Nissin, sino ba key brands niya? Kilalang-kilala natin, Lucky Me, Pancit Canton, yung instant noodles, mga cup noodles, Sky Flakes, syempre, Fita, yung Red, di ba? Tapos lots of other brands as well. You have ito, meat alternatives, mostly in the UK. And then not shown na rin, meron sila mga Dutch Mill yogurt drink, Monde, yung, ano pa ito, yung Mamon, di ba? So marami talaga silang binibenta. And for a lot of these, sila yung market leader in their segments, actually.
So sila pala yung biscuit lord sa Pilipinas, no?
Instant food, gusto mo paggutom ka, hungry college student, starving artist, whatever, meron kanyan. Lahat ng office may Sky Flakes, di ba?
Oo, tama. Sige, tignan natin kung may sense yung business, kung kamusta yung business nila.
Yep. So ito, so two businesses siya actually, or two segments yung pagtingin natin sa Monde Nissin. One is yung APAC, branded food and beverages. So ito talaga yung core business nila. Ito yung ano nila, Lucky Me, Sky Flakes, Fita, etc. And mostly yung sales nila nagagaling sa Philippines. And then yung second part is yung Corin and yung Cauldron, which is meat alternative business. So yung mga vegan, vegetarian options na it tastes like meat, it feels like meat, but it's not actually pork or chicken. So it's that kind of product. And then, so we're looking at yung net sales in Philippine pesos. So 53 billion pesos galing dun sa APAC business nila, yung core business talaga ng Monde Nissin. And then 15 billion pesos or 22% ng company galing sa meat alternatives. And then looking at how that translates to net income or loss. So actually, yung APAC business parang talaga yung profitable. Yung corn, yung meat alternative is a pretty new business. So hindi pa siya nagpa-profit. Pero yun, kita natin. So 8.9 billion pesos in profit as of for the year 2020. And then how does that translate to EPS, which will look at naman in the future slides then. So around 0.59 pesos of EPS, yung EPS nila galing sa APAC BFB. And then sa corn, since negative ba siya, let's not look at that right now, right? And then just looking at yung trend ng revenues nila. So itong APAC BFB, it's been growing at around 6.1% every year for the past 4 years. Versus yung corn, which has grown a bit slightly slower, so 5.1%. And one thing to note, diba, itong 15 billion pesos, 15.2, 15 billion pesos. So past 3 years, medyo flat lang yung revenues ni corn, even though it's an up-and-coming product. And that's explained in their prospectus that it's mostly because of supply chain issues and capacity issues ng manufacturing plants nila. And that's one thing that they want to address then with this IPO. Yeah. So overall stats ng IPO, yung offering price nila is 13.5 pesos per share. Overall EPS, as in combined of the entire Monde Nissin Corporation, is 0.53. So that puts it at a PE of 25.5x. And then, compare din natin, how does that compare ba versus other consumer companies in the Philippines, diba? Other food and beverage companies.
Yeah, so
just before, yeah, so just before that, diba? Looking at yung EPS CAGR nila, 32.3%. So parang high growth yung earnings, diba? But looking at saan ba galing yung growth na yan, if yung sales is growing at less than 10%, paano nangyari to? And looking at their financials, it's mostly because yung costs nila stayed flat. So medyo magaling sila sa cost optimization. It's possible na they're applying cost minimization strategies. It's also possible na they're achieving economies of scale.
Yeah. So good thing to highlight yun. So this is a consumer name pero relatively malaki na, giant levels. Tapos this is not achieving yung mga revenue growth na tipong 20%, 50% na exciting sa most consumer-related companies. No? So ito mas mature. But then the up-and-coming potential is kay Corn, which is a global brand na binili nila before. Diba? If you've heard of names like Beyond Meat and etc., ayun, tatalakayin rin natin ito kung bakit ba exciting yung corn. But for the local business, medyo mature stage company na siya, as we can see on the revenue trajectory.
Yep, and we mentioned that their brands are number one market leader, so it's pretty hard to be a fast-growing company or brand when you're already number one, right? And then ito, looking at other consumer names, so yung direct competitor talaga nila is Universal Robina Corporation, URC, kasi nagbibenta rin ng instant noodles, ng biscuits, ng drinks, right? I also put in here CNPF, San Miguel Food and Beverage, so Pure Foods, because in a sense, they're competitors na rin na, you know, you're making food locally and then you're selling it to mga groceries. So parang if you combine all of these four companies, take, let's say, 10 grade schoolers, 9 out of 10 siguro sa kanila merong at least one brand dyan sa baunan, right? And then looking at how these are currently trading versus their trailing 12-month EPS. So they're at around 24 times, 20 times, 26 times earnings versus yung sinabi natin itong si Monde nasa 25.5 times PE, right? So roughly within the range din siya in-offer. And looking at yung EPS CAGR, since URC 8%, medyo mature business na rin naman. And then these other two, well, medyo mas variable. Pero the one thing lang na a quick and easy way to value the APAC business ni Monde Nissin is take yung 0.59 pesos na attributable sa kanya. And then ito, let's look at different price niya at different PE ranges. So we're saying na if it trades at 18x, then you would expect na 10.56 pesos per share na lang. If it trades 22x, then you can expect 12.9 pesos attributable to yung value no yung APAC business niya, right? So it's pretty straightforward. You can grow two ways. One is to grow your EPS. The other one is to expand your PE. And typically that happens during bull markets, right? Or when there's an exciting story in your company. So for context lang, itong CURC nasa 24x ngayon. Pero pre-pandemic, mga 2018, it used to trade above 30x PE. So if the market recovers, expect na tataas din yung valuation of this business.
Yeah.
And then looking at yung corn business naman, ito yung mas exciting for me. And I think this is really where the growth story is. Because a meat alternative, this is a pretty new space and it's a potential megatrend over this decade. So they bought corn in 2015, acquired it 100%. It's a UK-based company. And mostly nanggagaling sa UK yung sales nila. Pero this Philippine company acquired it in 2015. That's how strong they were. And they were able to do that. And then, sino bang other key players in meat alternatives si Beyond Meat, si Impossible Foods, right? And just thinking back over the last 5 years, how many vegans or vegetarians did you know back then versus how many do you know today? Maybe not that much pa rin, pero for me, it's a significant increase. I know at least 3 people today versus most likely 0 back like 5 years ago. And then over the next decade, parang we're in the middle of a health crisis then. Even outside this pandemic, parang obesity at an all-time high rate in the US, right? Other health concerns. So the meat alternative space is one way to address that like ongoing crisis or health problem then.
Yeah.
So ito, just comparing corn versus Beyond Meat sales. So kahit quick Google search lang really. So si corn merong 15 billion pesos. Si Beyond Meat merong $406 million. And that's around 20 billion pesos. So around 30% higher lang siya versus corn. And yun, so medyo comparable yung business in terms of size. Pero the one thing is, itong si Beyond Meat, it's growing 36.6% year on year. So high growth talaga yung sales ni Beyond Meat versus si corn nga, na yun nga, encountered flat sales over the past 3 years, diba? So we can also see this growth being priced in sa valuation ni Beyond Meat. So we got the sales, right? Google din natin na yung market cap niya, 6.7 billion pesos, dollars. And so what that translates to is 16.5 times price to sales. And that is extremely high because a typical, let's say a boring food company, it would only trade at around 2 times price to sales. Ito 16.5x, right? So how do we value corn? If you want a quick and easy way to do it, you take the 15 billion net sales and then multiply it by some factor, right? Maybe not 16.5x because it's not as high growth right now. So looking at the potential ranges, right? Like what if we apply the boarding two times? So 1.67 pesos worth pala siya per share. Pero I don't expect that at all because it's not a boring company. It's in a potential megatrend space. So what if we try 4x times yung 15 billion sales niya? Then we're seeing around 3.35 pesos per share yung value nitong coin. And then what if it's, what if it goes closer to beyond meat? Then we're seeing itong mga 6.69, right? So when you add these two together, so it depends na lang on how you want to assess their businesses separately. So if I take, for example, 20 times yung APAC business niya, right? So that means 11.73 pesos yung value na expected ko from yung APAC business niya. And then let's say I want 4 times for corn, then I get 3.35. So if I add 11.73, 3.35, then my valuation using their 2020 figures is at around 15 pesos per share versus yung 13.5, right, offer price niya. So my upside siya, if you think of it that way. And then what if you're more aggressive? You say, ah, itong business ito could easily be 24x. So 14 pesos, that's just Monde Nissin alone. Mm. And then my, sorry, Monde Nissin, the local business. And then meron ka pang corn, right? So at 13.50 pesos, you're saying na, okay, I'm buying the Monde Nissin business and I'm getting corn for free. That's one way to look at it. And that's why they were aiming for a 17.5 peso yung maximum offer price din.
Mm. Yeah. So I think ano lang yung factor dito kasi medyo relatively stagnant pa yung mga emerging markets. Tapos pag tinignan mo on top view, hindi pa nga masyado obvious yung growth ni corn, di ba? Hindi pa siya nare-realized masyado. Pero maganda tong ginawa ni Ray na tinitignan natin siya, dinidig down natin ano ba yung potential ni corn pag relative comparison dun sa mga industry leaders or potential gaya ni Beyond Meat. So ayun, mukhang sa long term may ano no, may upside 15 to 17 pesos. Pero Ray, ano yung paggagamitan natin ng pera dito sa IPO na to? Kasi interesting yung ano allocation dito eh.
Yeah. So if you do buy at 13.50 pesos per share, where does your money go? It will mostly go to primary shares, so new shares yung i-issue ng company. So it's going straight to the company, not to yung existing shareholders niya. And so mga 46 billion yung net proceeds na estimate nila. And then 57% going to CapEx. The rest going to debt repayment kasi medyo mataas nga yung leverage nila right now. And then itong CapEx na to, we're seeing most of it is actually going to yung meat alternative business. Which is very interesting for me kasi diba, this is only 22% of the company. And this one is 78% itong Monde, itong local portion. Pero the way they're allotting yung IPO proceeds, they know where the focus is. They know where the growth market is. And that's where they're putting it in. So 15.7 billion pesos to expand yung capacity nila so that they can finally grow sales and maybe in the future make this a profitable business as well.
Yeah, so for me, that adds ano eh, long-term interest on this. So syempre, yung additional capital and capacity, hindi yan agad-agad lalabas, di ba? Probably it will take 6 months onward. Pero the fact na yung CapEx allocation nila, 60% nun ay lalagay nila dun sa corn, dun sa meat alternative business, knowing how people are more environmentally conscious, health conscious nowadays, or socially responsible, they're riding on the super trend. So tama to. Parang onti lang ina-allocate nila dun sa mature business, sa boring side of things, and then binabanatan nila tong corn, which can probably pwedeng mag ano to eh, super trend kung sakali kung ma-manage nila well yung mga supply chain and mga partnerships nila.
Yep, that's right. And sa industry research na part ng prospectus nila, they actually forecast na the entire market for meat alternatives, it's going to grow by around 17 times from 2020 to 2029. So it's really important and it's really huge potential if you succeed in this space, if you become one of the key players talaga. So ito, major risk naman, right? So we showed this one when we did the analysis for Converge. We also showed this for DDMPR. So si Converge was around above 25 billion pesos yung offer size niya. If we added Monde to this chart, it wouldn't actually fit in this chart. It would land right around here. So 48 to 55 billion peso yung offering niya. So 2 times larger siya than Converge. It's really our largest IPO ever. Kaya ayun, just temper expectations na if itong mga smaller ones, -5 to 16% lang yung performance, what more when you reach like this size of an IPO, right?
Yeah. So ayun guys, heads up dun. Potentially double than the biggest IPOs or yung recent IPO. So mabigat sa mabigat to. Kung yung mga dating inanalyze natin, mabigat na. Ito yung pinaka-heavyweight sa lahat. Okay. And then some things to consider. Interesting is, ano eh, unang offer price nila 17 plus, di ba? Tapos ngayon na-close sa 1350. So lower part of the range. Again, that tells us the clue na medyo mahirap ibenta sa premium, so binababa nila para mas madali ibenta sa mga investor. So, sabi dito sa news, tinaas nila yung allotment for retail investors to 1 million. So, this is, para sa akin, parang ano to eh, parang mas mag-iingat ako dito, caution flag siya for me. Because, ibig sabihin, mas kinakailangan nilang mag-feed ng supply or ng shares sa mga tao just to fill in the ideal size nila na 50 billion. So, mas may challenge i-distribute yung shares. So, that's one thing. Not necessarily bad, pero on a short-term supply and demand scenario, diba, that can be a potential caution na parang hindi natin kailangan magmadali. But then, on the long-term side of things, if you look at here on the lower box, 11 cornerstone investors daw yung kumuha ng 67% nung IPO nila. So na-corner na yung ano, yung na-corner na nung cornerstone investors yung 67. So one third na lang yung tinatry ibenta nung company. But still, yung one third na yun, bilyones pa rin, di ba? Mabigat pa rin. So may mga long-term believers na nakapwesto na dito. Kasi kita naman natin eh, yung position ng company, boring yung APAC business, yung Philippines business, pero yung corn in itself is a global business na nasa mega trend. So probably nakita nila yun. So mabigat on the short term, pero long term may mga naniniwala. So ganun yung assessment. Ngayon, on the next slide, naalala nyo kung tinignan nyo yung mga past reviews natin sa Investa ng mga IPOs, di ba? Karamihan dyan, may first week or first 1 to 3 days hype, 'di ba? Kasi excited yung mga tao, uy, bagong stock, so bibili sa ticker and all of that, may mga excitement. Pero what we've seen so far, lalo na yung market natin in 2020 and 2021, hindi tayo nasa bull market na straight up trend agad eh. Most of the time yung first week nagkakaroon ng correction, ano yan, correction phase, 'di ba? Yung mga impatient or yung mga investor na gusto lang mag-liquidate, nagtatapon. So, nakukuha natin at a discount. And that's the same thing that we see dito kay Monde Nissin. Lalo na ang bigat niya. Pasok siya dun sa parameters natin na mabigat. So, hindi natin kailangan magmadali. Dahil doble siya dun sa size nung statistical test na ginagawa namin ni Ray, expect natin hindi yan tatakbo na biglang lilipad 20% in the first week. Diba? Probability is on our side na may allowance tayo dito, pwede tayong mas maging patient. So let's look at the summary, Ray.
Yeah. So ito, final verdict, right? So for conservative investors, we think that we can wait at around 20 to 22 times PE. So that's around the 10 to 15% dip. So at 11.5 to 12.5 range, right? And really, again, what you're looking for here is potential upside in the medium to long term, driven by yung potential megatrend of meat alternatives. So think of it, one way to think of it talaga is at 13.50, you're buying Monde Nissin, the local business. If corn makes it, congratulations, may profit ka. If it doesn't, edi okay lang, you bought like another URC and you can keep that in your portfolio for a long term, right? And then yung major risk, right? So we discussed this in earlier, it's 2 times the size of Converge. It's really the largest IPO so far. So if you convert that to dollars, $1 billion offering na rin yan. Magiging market cap niya is 240 billion pesos, right, from the start versus yung mga URC mo nasa 280, right? So medyo malapit-lapit na rin.
Yep.
And then other risks, of course, yung market sentiment, which we discussed. So that's been ongoing for the past 2 years na. And it's still here. And let's see, maybe we haven't bottomed yet. But eventually, I think we will then. The economy will start to recover, the market will start to recover. So yeah, it's a risk, but also potential upside because of the current situation. And then for traders.
Ayun. for traders, ayun, yung kagaya no sa mga pattern nila, converge nila, yung mga recent IPOs, pwede nating antayin yung base formation, di ba? So, kahit anong volatility within the first 3 to 5 days, kung makakuha tayo at the dip, that's good. Pero hindi tayo kailangan maging ma-FOMO kasi bubuo ng base yan, kagaya na nakita natin kay A-REIT, kay Converge. And then within the 2 to 6 month period, kapag nag-materialize na yung understanding ng mga tao sa fundamentals and sa business nung company, plus probably kung maging positive na yung sentiment sa Pilipinas and sa mundo, then ayun, dun lalabas yung breakout. So for traders, yun na lang yung antayin natin. One thing to consider here is yung valuation niya, 'di ba, 25 times PE ngayon. Pero yung revenue growth nung main driver, yung local company, yung APAC, medyo boring eh. 6% growth lang yung nangyayari. So this is not like, 'di ba, nung inanalyze natin sila Converge or dati yan sila URC, nag-grow yan 20%, minsan 40%. Yep. So ito pretty mature business siya. So the reason why consumer companies are trading 25 times, 30 times is because yung revenue growth, yung sales growth mataas, yung excitement mataas. So this one, yung bulk ng business niya is at a boring 6%, very mature. So it will take some time and execution for the corn potential, the meat alternative story to happen, no. So nandun yung long term, pero in the short term expect natin na magiging ano muna to, magko-consolidate or magda-dull down. So, ayun, to close out, balik tayo sa summary, Ray. Ayun, so mga ka-invest, ayun. Kung long-term investor ka na gusto mo lang magkaroon ng allocation sa portfolio, sure, pwede ka kumuha nito. Pero given the current market sentiment and valuations, yung majority ng allocation natin, pwede nating iabang yan. Pwede tayong magbarat or bumili sa discount dito. Tapos, nandiyan yung long-term potential, pero sa mga traders, ano lang, chill lang. Antayin natin yung tamang setup. Darating rin yan sa atin. So, among the past 5 IPOs or 4 IPOs that we've tackled, interesting yung Converge. Ito interesting rin kasi potentially riding on a mega trend. And I think yung bigat niya can be an opportunity na, uy, bababa yung presyo for a while, magsistabilize muna to bago talagang sumipa, bago lumabas yung totoong fruits nila, 'di ba? I-invest pa lang nila yung 60% ng capex dun sa plant-based alternatives, meat alternatives. Yun yung exciting, pero it will take time. So I'm excited for this. Lahat naman tayo kumakain ng biskwit. Pero ano? mga anak natin, mga pinsan natin kumakain ng biskwit all around us. Pero ano, makakaantay tayo sa tamang pagkakataon dito. So ayun mga ka-investor, Ray, ikaw anong final ano mo, message mo?
Ang magandang tanong is, lahat tayo kumakain ng biskwit ngayon, pero 5 years from now, lahat ba tayo kumakain ng meat alternatives na? We ayun. Don't know, right? So if you watch yung mga documentaries sa Netflix, meron yung what do you call that, Game Changers, meron ding What the Health, parang convincing talaga eh. So let's see what's gonna happen in this space. And we're saying here about 3 to 6 months base and breakout. It might even take longer than that kasi for me, the catalyst talaga is the catalyst that the market is waiting for is to see yung real potential in the corn. If they can grow sales by 100% in 2 years or whatever, if they can turn a profit, yun ang catalyst talaga for me. So yeah, exciting company, may stable base ka, and then meron kang uncertain pero potential huge upside on top of that.
Yep. Mature company on the right priorities and direction. So exciting to see how it will manifest. So ayun, thank you Ray for your time and insights. I'm sure marami na naman tayong matutulungan and mag-guide dito. And I hope mga ka-investa natuto kayo and matulungan kayo nitong analysis natin. So for more content and educational videos, subscribe lang kayo sa Investa TV. So maraming salamat and kita-kits ulit next time. Thank you everyone.